Just an hour northwest of Sydney on the banks of the Hawkesbury River sits picturesque Pitt Town. For 12 years, it was the backdrop for a country practice. But the region is prone to devastating floods.
It's got that much power, you can't stop it, you can't go near it. It picks up everything in its path. You can't explain it, how much damage it causes. It's catastrophic.
In the past 12 months, the people of Pitt Town have faced three major floods.
We are probably one of the most vulnerable towns in New South Wales when it comes to flooding.
Whenever it rains, you're always worried you're going to lose your power, lose your sewerage, lose your communication.
But they have another serious problem.
Once we experience heavy flooding, we get isolated down to one road in and out.
And this is it. This is the very last option if you just have to get out.
When the water rises, evacuation is near impossible, and locals have been pleading with the New South Wales government for a safer way out.
The roads become very rough with lots of potholes, a lot of mud. It's time for the government to act.
In the early 90s, Pitt Town had a population of around 300, but the numbers exploded to nearly 4,000 after a developer promised huge infrastructure upgrades, with new roads like the flood evacuation route and town bypass, sporting fields and a boat ramp. So far, there's been no sign of those improvements, leaving locals still with only one escape route.
We certainly expected that in a reasonable time frame we would have a fit-for-purpose evacuation route, not a goat track, which is only one disaster away from being inaccessible for us to be able to escape.
We've been shortchanged and, to be honest, we've been misled.
Peter Ryan's family has lived in Pitt Town for five generations.
We're a small, vulnerable community here, and to be treated this way by government, that's just unconscionable.
In 2017, the state government took over responsibility for infrastructure. At the time, now Premier Dominic Perrottet was the member for Hawkesbury and said he was completely committed to having the bypass built.
When a politician makes a promise, especially to a small community, they have to follow through.
A report this year recommended that the government fund the improvement of the Pitt Town evacuation route. The state government says this will happen, but has yet to commit to a deadline.
It's my expectation as Minister for Roads, it's my responsibility and expectation that that will happen. And that's why we have funding in place, to ensure that that work can start. And we're working closely with those communities to ensure that we hear from them and that we get this right.
I'm sick to death of hearing about community consultation and resilience work groups and all this sort of stuff. I just think they need to do something right now.
The same roads exist today as existed 40 years ago, so we can't even evacuate schools every day to pick up kids, let alone evacuate people in a flood.
Professor Ian Wright is an environmental scientist. He's calling for a halt to new estates amidst warnings that 40,000 people could be at risk of flooding by 2040 if developments continue to be built around the Hawkesbury-Nepean floodplain.
I think we need a moratorium of urban development until we have an urban strategy that can help make this whole community flood resilient.
Natalie Ward says the raising of the Warragamba dam wall about 50 kilometres upstream is part of the government's long-term plan to tackle the floods.
And the Premier has confirmed that we are committed to that project.
But some Pitt Town locals are unconvinced.
We don't need to wait 7, 8, 9 years and spend $1.5 billion on a second dam wall. That is not the silver bullet to fix this. How many more floods and how many more families are going to be devastated and impacted by floods over the next 7 to 8 years?
With big rains predicted in the coming weeks, residents are worried there's not enough time left to protect the town.
Immediately they could look at lowering Warragamba Dam over the next few weeks to knock the top off the flood height. And they could be immediately working on trying to upgrade the flood access route so that it's fit for purpose.
As Pitt Town prepares for the worst, their message to the New South Wales Premier is clear.
I'm not sure if people are going to be resilient enough to be able to bounce back from a full flood come September if the forecasts are true.
It's time to live up to your word. It's time for the government to come out here and fix the wrongs of the past. We've had enough.
Obviously, there is so much talk about community consultation in response to all of these natural disasters. But I think something we really have seen, particularly this year with the flooding, is that it is local communities that know, firstly, what the problems are in those spaces and what the fixes, the likely fixes are. So you really do hope that when they talk about community consultation, they mean it. Because it's clear that that's actually the only way that they'll find an answer.
But 7 years since Dominic Perrottet made that promise. Good news is there's a New South Wales state election coming right up.